Learning the ropes. How to manage your RV systems. Having an RV brings with it a whole new set of rules to learn. When you're at home, features like power, lighting, hot water, and septic toilets are taken for granted. They usually work with a minimum of fuss, and we're so used to caring for them that it's second nature to us. We still have most of those features in an RV, but they must be cared for in a different way to give years of trouble-free usage. Most RVs have three water tanks: fresh water, gray water, and black or toilet-flushed water. Of these three, the black water tank needs the most attention. For starters, you must only use the type of toilet paper that's considered suitable, otherwise a blockage could occur. It needs to be treated with the proper chemicals to prevent waste buildup and odor. There are many brands and types, but a liquid one that contains no formaldehyde is best. Put some of it in the gray water tank also, as there are chemicals in it that help to lubricate the pump valves. Water tank chemicals should contain cleaners, waste digesters, toilet tissue digesters, deodorizers, drain valve lubricants, and gauge sensor cleaners. 40-gallon tank needs about 4 ounces, but in extra hot weather, you may need to double the amount. An enzyme-based chemical is good, as it uses live bacteria to do the job. It has low toxicity and less impact on the environment than harsher chemicals. Unfortunately, it does tend to lose its effectiveness in extremes of temperature and pH. It should be introduced into a clean tank for best results. The freshwater system should be kept sanitized for safety. It gets hooked up to all kinds of water, and you never know for sure if it's totally pure. Always use a filter, and if the water smells stale at any time, drain it all out and use a solution of bleach or vinegar and water for cleansing. When you're ready to store your RV, you'll need to add antifreeze to all the water systems. Your RV manual should tell you what to do and how to do it in more detail. The furnace on your RV is another vital piece of equipment. It needs to be kept in good repair, since a faulty one could kill you, or at least give an unpleasant few days of cold temperatures and no hot water. Never allow the inside vents to be obstructed, and check the outside ones for soot. If there is soot on them or fluff on the inside ones, that's a sign that repair is needed. Always be sure to get all your RV systems checked out thoroughly, both before and after you go on an RV trip.